Good morning and welcome to America's Home Cooking. Today we are making New York pumpernickel bread. All right, now we need 3/4 of a cup of water and we're going to bring it to a boil. Do not use hot water from the faucet. It's got sediments in it that will give your liver and your system a hard time, and it cannot get rid of it easily. Cannot stress that enough. So we're going to bring this water to a boil. And we're going to get a small bowl. And we are going to get 1 cup of raisins. When that water comes to a boil, we're going to pour the water over the raisins and let them soak. If I can get them out of here. You're not going to eat that taffy.
No, you will worry about it.
There's one more, half a cup of meat. Almost got it. Okay, we got that. Okay. We want cocoa powder. We want 1.5 tablespoons. I don't know how much I have in here, so I'm going to go over that. And now we're going to add to it 1.5 tablespoons of strong coffee to the cocoa. I took my older son's coffee because he likes really strong coffee. I don't think he'll mind. Got this sitting. I want you to mix this before we start adding other stuff. And I said, okay. Now, when I make this bread, I use a dark rye. I do not use a light rye. There are two different kinds. You have the dark rye and the light rye. I'm waiting for that to boil so we can continue moving.
All right. Now we're going to sit there and
Add a teaspoon of sugar. Using regular yeast this time. We are not using sourdough culture. And let's see, that's 2.5 teaspoons. Okay. Make sure this is dry. 2 1/4, I think it is. Yeah, 2 1/4. I use so much sourdough, but I buy this just for other recipes I have that I haven't been able to convert yet. And believe you me, my family loves 1.5 cups of lukewarm water. When they're talking lukewarm, what they're talking about is just wrist temperature. So you just really are just taking a slight chill off the water. That's all you're doing. It doesn't take long, but I will never, ever, like I said, I'm not going to use what they want me to use. I'm not going to do it. Of course, I'm not making it the way they want to make it. I'm going to make it my way, and that's going to upset them. Now we need 1/3 cup of molasses. Now this bread is going to take a little longer to rise because it's got a lot of whole grains in it. For salt, you're going to need 2 teaspoons of salt. I think I'm done with that. I've added everything. Got it too hot. I got mine a little too hot. I'll pour 1/2 cup out and 1/2 cup of cold, and it will be lukewarm. And that's how you adjust it. If you overheat it, throw some of the heat out. And add cold water to the water that's too hot, and you will notice that it will work out just fine. All right, when am I adding the raisins? Oh, really?
Okay.
Drain your raisins.
God, that's hot still.
Dump them in. Rye flour. We are going to add 2.5 cups of rye flour. Into this one recipe. This bread is great cream cheese on it. I don't know why it really is. Now we're going to add whole wheat to this.
And we need 1.5 cups of whole wheat. Last but not least, they want bread flour. Okay. Get you out of my way. Now, how much of this do they want? 2 to 3 cups of bread flour. As you can see, this is going to take a long time to rise. And I haven't even added the bread flour yet, so you can just imagine. I'm actually going to knead it right down here on the counter. They're not using all-purpose flour because they know yeast loves this bread flour. It's its favorite flour. I haven't made this one in years. I remember it was very heavy and it took forever to rise. It was so good. I remember correctly, it didn't take all the flour either. This doesn't make a huge loaf, but it's a delicious loaf. It's a heavy loaf. It'll stick to your ribs. It's also excellent with soups. Let me finish kneading this cup in, and I'll be back. Okay, mine did not take a whole cup of flour. Yours does? All right, but the recipe says 2 to 3 cups of bread flour. But with everything they put in it, it does not, it does not, it just does not. So I usually will put a cup out and just let it. I remembered when I was working it, I said, oh yeah, that's right. I only put a cup of bread flour out and work as much as I can in. And this is a heavy loaf with everything that's put in it, but it's so good with stews. I am not kidding. And we put cream cheese on it and had it with coffee when I could have coffee, and it was delicious. So it's a good bread. It just doesn't take that much flour. And somebody has a secret that I don't know about, and they forgot to put something in. And I did exactly what they said. So this bread's gonna take, it could take, because the weather is cool where I'm at, it could take longer than 2 hours, but they're stating a 2-hour rise on it. So I can't answer how long, but it will not be an hour, that much I know. I'm going to grease the inside of a bowl. The reason you grease the bowl is you don't want your bread to dry out. And you say, but I'm going to put it in and the top won't be greased. Yes, it will be. Because going to turn this bread upside down, press it down, make sure it's coated on the top, you spin it around, make sure it's coated, then you flip it over to the other side, make sure that it's all coated. This, I remember, this takes a long time to rise. Okay, I'm going to be putting two towels over this because I know it's got to stay very, very warm. I'm remembering it now as I see it and I'm working with it. Oh yeah, I remembered it needed this, it needed that, it needed to really stay warm. And if I have to, I'll put a lid over it too. Okay, so we'll wait till that doubles and I'll be back. I just realized I'm going to have two parts on making this bread because there's something else that I have to do. So I'll see you in part two.